Hi guys, it's me, Nap Queen, aka Shayna. If you guys would like to see how I got this Romeo Must Die fresh relaxer looking straight on fleek, shiny, any other descriptive words or phrases you guys can use or find to describe how my hair looks right now, if you guys want to know how I achieved this, stay tuned. I did straighten my hair. I kind of was against straightening because the only time that I straightened my hair this year in June, I ended up with heat damage. Straightening my hair really isn't anything new to me. I did it like 5 times last year and it was perfect. It was great, no heat damage. But when I did it in June, I didn't do what I usually do, you know. When you feel confident about something, you did it 100 times, you know that you got it. Sometimes you get lazy and you get cocky, and that's what I did in June, and I didn't do my regular steps that I know that I need to do to avoid heat damage, and I ended up getting heat damage. So I kind of deserved it, but it really broke my heart because I really love taking care of my hair and growing my hair in a healthy way. And after I got heat damage, my feelings was just hurt. Like, I don't know, like I hurt my own feelings when I damaged my hair. But why I straightened my hair this time is because my hair is uneven, so I want to give myself a legit trim. I talk about not trimming in a lot of my videos because I don't really trim my hair. I like to maintain my hair in a very healthy way to the point where I don't have damage and I don't need to trim. But because I did damage my hair this year, it's important for me to pretty much trim and just start brand new. So that was my motive behind straightening my hair, but it's like literally so on fleek, I might wear it for 2 weeks this way. So I'm gonna start this. So I began by co-washing my hair with Tresemme's Moisture Rich Anti-Breakage Silicone Conditioner. A lot of people demonize sulfates and silicones, but when you're straightening your hair, it's very important to use silicone-based products because that's really going to form a barrier of protectant for your hair from the heat tools that you're about to use. So you want to make sure that you do condition with a silicone conditioner. When you get a knot, you want to make sure that you take out all of the individual hair strands that make up that knot. You don't want to just yank the knot out with your fingers or brush, but the shower is where I really take my time to detangle my hair thoroughly. It's where it's easiest to detangle my hair underneath running water. And even when I'm not straightening my hair, even when I'm maintaining my hair throughout the year in a natural way, I usually mainly do all of my detangling in the shower under running water, and you'll see this in other videos of mine. So you want to make sure that you really detangle your hair good in the shower, because that's what will make the process easier once you get out. I like to use a paddle brush in the shower. I find that it works better for me than a Denman, just because it has a greater like area that it covers. So with it covering a greater area, that separates my hair better. After you detangle each section, you want to be sure to braid it up, and that is what will keep your hair stretched and detangled. As soon as your hair shrinks back up, if you have 4C hair like I do, it takes no time at all for it to shrink back up. And as soon as it shrinks back up, that's when it's no longer detangled. That's why it seems like you can comb your hair and brush it really good, and then 2 seconds later, it's back to being tangled. So you want to make sure you braid it up after each section is detangled to keep it stretched. So now I'm just taking out one of the sections and applying the 2 products that I used before blow drying, which was Luster's Pink and Olive Oil's Heat Protecting Serum. And I used about a nickel size amount of each. When blow drying, I detangle first with my Denman, and then I just hold my hair taut. I don't feel it's necessary to completely go through with the brush each pass while you're
blow drying, I just hold my hair taut and use the blow dryer to dry the hair. And it's just the most important thing is to just keep your hair stretched while it's drying. So you want to hold the ends and just extend your hair and dry it. There's no need to consistently run through your hair with the brush while you're blow drying. And if you feel like you can detangle a little bit more, go ahead and detangle after your hair is about 70% dry, and then continue drying it by holding it taut. And of course, braid your hair right back up after you're finished blow drying so that it will stay detangled and stretched. So I'm going to show you guys the process one more time. Apply both products, the Luster's Pink and the Olive Oil Heat Protectant Serum. And then you want to detangle your hair. Your hair pretty much should be very well detangled from the good job that you did in the shower, which makes blow drying a breeze. But you want to make sure that the brush can go through your hair from root to tip. And if your hair is too thick like mine's was, you can separate the section into two to make detangling it and stretching it much easier. But you want to make sure the brush can go through it from root to tip, and then just hold the hair taut and use the air from the blow dryer to dry it. You don't have to consistently put the brush through your hair to dry it. That is a lot of manipulation that can use up the products that you're putting on your hair with the manipulation. So you want to preserve those products for the heat of the flat iron, and you don't want to manipulate your hair as much. With us having 4C hair, our hair is the furthest away from straight. So when you're straightening your hair after having your hair natural, it's really going through the most manipulation that you can put through your hair. Taking it from 4C tightly coiled hair to straight, you know, 4C is the furthest away from straight on the hair chart. So you want to cut down on manipulation as much as possible because you're manipulating your hair a lot already.
And your parts don't have to be perfect, but you do want to use a comb to part, because using your fingers can make really, really super uneven parts, and that won't really work well. So my flat iron is very old. If you saw my first original How I Flat Iron My 4C Hair video, you saw this very old flat iron where the paint is chipping. And basically, I just don't flat iron my hair enough for me to feel the need to invest in a new flat iron. So I'm just going to continue using that one because it works very well despite how old it looks. It has a setting from 1 to 30, and I have mine set on 20, so it's not halfway, it's like a little bit more than halfway. But with the amount of heat protectant I'm using, I'm very confident that I will not get heat damage. So I'm going to brush my hair with a dimming brush just to where it goes through without being caught. And once I get to that point, I'm going to chase the dimming brush with the flat iron. And with this method, even on 4C hair, you should only need one pass. And you don't want to spend longer than 3 seconds on any part of the strand. Very, very straight, but still very protected. So I'm going to do the same on this side. Spray some Isoplus. And
So, lastly, I'm going to show you guys how to flat iron those edges, because as you see, having super shiny straightened hair but still completely natural edges just does not really cut it. So in order to straighten my edges, I just brush all of my hair back and I just use one side of the flat iron, so one of the blades, to rub the edge hair. Of course, you want to spray your Isoplus oil sheen first, but you're going to use one half of the flat iron, one braid, to just rub the edge hair. And you might get too close and burn yourself, like I do a couple of times, but you want to just get as close as possible without burning yourself and rub the edge hair with the flat iron blade, and that will lay those hairs down and make them much easier to gel down or apply whatever kind of edge control product you would like to put on top of it. I'm pretty much just going to wear them brushed, but if I were going out, I would definitely like put some gel or some edge control on it. But yes, look at those. Okay, yes. And you just want to repeat on the other side. So these are the products that I used. I use Organigrowhairco Prepoo, which is just an oil mixture. I put that on my hair right before I got into the shower to detangle. I co-washed with Tresemme's Moisture Defense Conditioner, and I used the Luster's Pink and Ores as a heat protectant, and then the Isoplus Oil Sheen.
Okay, so if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you know a natural that could benefit from this video, share it. Share it on Facebook, copy the link, text it to a friend. Do whatever you want with it, but I just hope that it helped in some way and I hope you enjoyed it. If you would like to see more from me, be sure to hit the subscribe button below. And also all of my social media links are below in the description box. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!